Welcome back. And recently we hit 250 subscribers, which is pretty epic. And I wanted to make a video, number one, thanking you guys because it's pretty crazy. And number two, I wanted to go over the gear I use at 250 subscribers because there's something that I'm extremely excited for. And if you guys subscribe to this channel, you guys are gonna love the next video I post. So stay tuned for next week's video. But I wanna go ahead and film this video before I film that video because it's very exciting. And I wanted to go over what I have now when I hit 250 subscribers. So that's why I have my iPhone here. And I'm gonna go ahead and film on this and show you what's recording this right now. And this is what I'm looking at while I film my videos. I'm looking at a Sony RX100 Mark IV point and shoot. Very good Sony from camera. We're actually gonna stop recording that. I'm using a Gikoto tripod. Now I've actually had this camera for like 2 years now, so I've had it for a while. It's done really well. You can see I've taken pretty good care of it, customized it a little bit, and this thing has served me very well. It's actually starting to get a little bit older. It's starting to do a few things like kind of glitchy, but it's working really well. So if you're actually thinking of getting a good cheaper camera at this point, I would recommend getting an RX100 Mark IV or any RX100 just as like a pocketable point and shoot camera. This camera retails still for $998, but you can actually find it on eBay used and hopefully locally, that's how I got mine, for $300 to $600. So it's a pretty affordable camera if you get it used, and it served me very faithfully. So like I said, this is the Gikoto tripod. There's the model. I've actually made a video on this tripod, so that is coming up right here. And I actually haven't had it for that long, but it hasn't skipped a beat on me yet, and it's working really well. Next up, I also use this if I'm out, and you can't really use this vlogging with the tiny RX100, but this thing has served me very well just for getting cool shots. And also if you want to attach a little light to your tripod or something, this thing is great and very versatile. This is the Joby Gorillapod SLR Zoom. I've had this for I think a little bit over 3 years, and the legs are still holding out pretty well. I've got a little bit of a crack in this leg right here, which I've tried to fix, but it still holds pretty well in that leg. And if we look, if I pop this out right here, I can hold it here and it's pretty sturdy still. So I'd recommend getting one of these. You can't get the white one anymore. You actually can only get like the black and red model, which actually I can show you. It's this one right here, but this is the 5K. Yeah, I have this because of next week's video. Super pumped. I haven't opened it yet, but that's what the new one looks like. Just it's a little bit smaller than this one. And then I also have this, which is the Rode Video Micro. I actually got this when I was looking at cameras earlier last year, and this thing works really well. Just haven't had a chance to really use it yet. It's kind of funny just to have one of these laying around that you can't plug into anything, but let's just say we might also fix that problem soon. And if you actually watched that clip of the 5K Gorillapod that I just showed you, you might be able to get a good idea of what we're talking about in the next video. Now, that's about all the camera gear I use in my videos, other than like the GoPro Session 5, and I do have a Hero 3, which I don't really use that often for videos. But my only other really piece of gear, if you consider it a piece of gear, is my M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch with the upgraded 512 gigs of RAM. This is what I use to edit all my videos on. This thing hasn't skipped a beat since I've got it. I've only had it for like a month or two, but this thing has worked really well, and right now I have no complaints about it or the macOS system. This thing has worked really well, and as you can see right now, there's just not a whole lot of gear to go over. And also, if you're wondering about my light, it's like a cheap like $15-$20 LED light that I zip tied to the top of my blinds, so it gives me some nice simulated sunlight from a window, so it works pretty well. But that's about basically everything in my kit. It's probably good that I don't have like a look at my Arri Alexa that I use for my 250 subscriber channel. So that just kind of proves, really, if you want to start YouTube and start making videos, I actually started filming my videos on a old Canon point and shoot, and I absolutely loved it until it broke. But that just kind of shows you, if you guys want to start a channel in 2021, I'd say it's not too late. And really, you have everything you need to start a channel in your pocket, so go start one if you haven't yet. There you go, guys. That's my setup at 250 subscribers. Once again, I want to say thank you guys, and I post a video every week on Friday, sometimes two, very rarely though. So thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video or found it helpful. If you did, maybe you can go under this video and you will see my channel logo. If you click that, it'll bring you to all my other videos to get to 250 subscribers, and they're pretty interesting. So thank you guys for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Also, next week, pretty exciting. Stay tuned.